Hi viewers, today we will discuss about family Caesalpinaceae. Caesalpinaceae, the systematic position is class dicotyledons, subclass polypetale, series caulisflorae, order rosales, family leguminaceae, subfamily Caesalpinaceae. It is the systematic position. Now discuss about some important plants of this family. They are Cassia auriculata. The common name is Thangedu. Here auricle means ear shaped. Which are ear shaped? This Thangedu plant, this Cassia auriculata plant shows some important characters. What are they? In Thangedu plant, it has compound leaves. This is the compound leaf. So, the compound leaf has pulvinous petiole. Pulvinous petiole. It is one of the main character. It is the pinna, unipinna. These are leaflets. These leaflets are pairs, even numbers. So unipinnate with peripinnate. Peri means parallel, pairs, even number. There is no odd leaflet. All the leaves are arranged in pairs. That's why peripinnate. Unipinnate means only one pinna is there. Over the pinna, many leaflets are present. Together, it is called compound leaf. So, unipinnate, peripinnate, compound leaves are present. As well as, the petiole is pulvinous petiole. Pulvinous means a cushion-like, pillow-like, swallown petiole is called pulvinous petiole. It is identification character of leguminaceae. As well as, from this, pulvinous petiole has stipule. The stipule looks like ear shape. The ear is called auricle. Auriculated stipules are present in Cassia. The Cassia plants has more tannins. So these tannins are help to the treatment of derma diseases, skin diseases. So the tannins are helps in leather industries. Same time, the tannins are help to the treatment of skin diseases. So Cassia auriculata shows a special inflorescence that is called corymb. Corymb means in the inflorescence. In the inflorescence, all the flowers are in same height, but peduncles are different lengths. Such type of inflorescence is called corymb. All the flowers are same height. They are arranged in same height, but pedicels are different lengths. Pedicels are different lengths. Flowers are arranged in same height. Such type of inflorescence is called corymb. So the corymbous type inflorescence present in Cassia auriculata. So the Cassia auriculata generally growing at dry lands. So auriculated stipules are present. That's why the name came from that stipule character, Cassia auriculata. Next one, Cassia occidentalis. common name Casyntha. Casia tora, sickle senna. This plant growing as wild. Casia angustifolia, commonly, popularly as senna. Casia fistula, the common name Rela. The Rela plant also growing as wild. The plant flowers are edible. Sometimes some people are preparing curries from the petals of these flowers. Bahinia valai. Bahinia valai, commonly it is known as addaku. In Bahinia valai, the leaves looks like this manner, dichotomous. So, like this manner, the leaves are dichotomous, dilobed. It is called addaku. These addaku leaves are useful for making of plates. Bahinia valai is one of the lyen. Lyen. Lyen means even the plant has woody stem. Hence the plants are climbing over the another plant. Such character is called lyen. Once again, the plants has woody stems. Hence the plants are climbing over the another plant by the help of tendrils. Such type of plants are called lyens. So the Bahinia valai has tendrils. Tendrilar plant. Another one, Bahinia purpurea, common name Deva Kanchanam. Caesalpinia pulcherrima, Sima Tumma. Delonyx regia, commonly it is known as Gulmohar. Or Yerra Thurai, Yerra Thurai. So Delonyx regia generally growing among the roads. The petals are looks like a nails. Nails like petals are present in Delonyx regia. It is a good ornamental plant. Our Indian Forestry Department introduced this plant for favor of forest development. The plant is Delonyx regia. One more important on Delonyx regia. Among these all plants, the pollination mechanism by entomophily means insect pollination. But in Delonyx regia, bird pollination does. The bird pollination is called ornithophily. Ornithophily. Ornithophily means bird pollination. So the bird pollination takes place in Delonyx regia. In this plant, the flowers are big in size, deep red color, easily attract to the birds. So commonly it is known as Gulmohar. In North India, the plant calling as Gulmohar. In South India, the plant calling as Thurai. So ornithophily visible in this plant. Hardwickia bineta, common name AP or Peddap. So one important character behind this plant, Hardwickia bineta has a hard and durable wood. Durable wood available from this plant. Hard and durable wood available from this plant. It is important for entrance view. So in Caesalpinaceae family, the durable wood timber available in Hardwickia bineta, common name is AP. Next, one more important, Hematoxylon campechianum, common name logwood. Hemato means red color or blood color. Hemato, heme means iron. Iron gives red color or blood color. Hematoxylon, xylem. So the red color present in xylem of this plant. Species name is Campechianum. So Hematoxylon Campechianum, the xylem contain the red color dye, that is hematoxylin. Hematoxylin, it is one of the red color dye. The red color dye available from the wood of xylem. The hematoxylin dye help to the nucleus of the cell. Nucleus of the cell. So dyeing for the nucleus of the cell. So the color turns into reddish color. The nucleus color turns into reddish color. So it is one of the important character of the Caesalpinaceae. It is important for entrances. The nucleus of the cell dyeing by the hematoxylin. Next one, Saraca indica. Common name Sita Asoka. Mostly these plants are growing at North India. For example, in front of Taj Mahal, these plants are visible. Saraca indica. Some important characters. In Saraca indica, no petals. There are petals are absent. No corolla in Saraca indica. Next one, Tamarindus indica. The common name tamarind. Tamarind. So tamarind fruits are indehiscent fruit, sour taste. The pulp is laxative. Laxative means, so free motions are coming when we are taking this pulp soup. So it is useful as laxative. Some C vitamin also available from this fruit. One more important in tamarindus. The tamarindus has 3 sepals, 3 petals, 3 stamens. So the number of stamens are 3. Fertile stamens are 3. But 4 staminodes also present. Staminodes. Staminodes means sterile stamens. Totally 7. Number of stamens are 7 in tamarindus. 3 stamens are fertile. 4 stamens are sterile. They are called staminodes. But usually in the tamarindus, the number of the sepals are 3. Number of the petals are 3. Number of the fertile stamens are 3. As well as monodelpus. These 3 and 4 together 7. The 7 stamens are monodelpus. Monodelpus means the 7 stamens are present in one bundle. That is called monodelpus. It is important for entrances. The number of the stamens, fertile stamens are 3. Next, Parkinsonia aculeata. Usually it is called Parkinsonia. It is xerophyte. A pure xerophytic plant. So from the Caesalpinaceae has only one xerophyte, that is Parkinsonia aculeata. In Parkinsonia aculeata, stipules are modified into spines. It is one of the modification. So in Caesia auriculata, stipules are ear shaped. That's why auricle shaped stipules. But in Parkinsonia, stipules are modified into spines. Now we are discussing the detailed explanation of this family characters. They are divided into two parts, vegetative characters and floral characters. The vegetative characters has habitat, habit, root, stem, leaf, as well as floral characters are divided into inflorescence, flower, calyx, corolla, androecium, gynoecium, pollination type, fruit, seed, floral formula. Now we are discussing one by one. We discuss about habitat. Most of the plants are mesophytes. But Parkinsonia except. So Parkinsonia is xerophyte. Remaining all plants are mesophytes. Habit. I already noticed all the Fabaceae members are herbs. All the Caesalpinaceae members are shrubs. All the Mimosaceae members are trees. Most of this family, the plants are belongs to shrubs. Now vegetative characters, root, tap root system. Because these are dicotyledons. Stem, aerial, woody. The stems are woody nature generally. But the stems has tannin, gum cavities. So stems and leaves has tannin and gum cavities. Bahinia vali. Plant is lichen. For example, Bahinia. Define lichen. Which plants are has woody stem, hence they are climbing another plants by the help of tendrils. They are called lichens. In Bahinia, the tendrils are arising at leaf axils. So from leaf axil, two tendrils are arising. By the help of tendrils, the plant can climb on another plant. That nature is called lichen. Leaves. Usually, leaves are compound leaves. Stipulate. Stipules are present. In Caesia, the stipules are auricle shape. Important. Delonyx. Stipules are foliar shape. In Parkinson, spines. So the leaves have stipules. The stipules are modified into auricle shape of stipule in Caesia auriculata, foliar shape of stipules in Delonyx region. Spines are origin from stipules from Parkinsonia. The leaves are unipinnate, unipinnate, peripinnate. Example, tamarindus. I already noticed. But some plants has bipinnate, peripinnate. Compound leaves are present. For example, Delonyx regia. In Delonyx, the compound leaf has two pinnates. So it is one pinna, it is another pinna. The pinna has many pairs of the leaflets. So many pairs. These pairs are even number. Such a type of compound leaf is called bipinnate. It is one pinna, it is another pinna. The second pinna has leaflets. The leaves are pairs, even number. So bipinnate, peripinnate, compound leaves are present in Delonyx regia. In Delonyx regia, the stipule also shows bipinnate, peripinnate, compound leaf-like stipules are present. So the stipule and compound leaf are identical shape. So the stipules also very resemble to the compound leaf in Delonyx regia. Now reticulate venation is very common. Now inflorescence. Simply the inflorescence is resin. But in Caesia species, corymb. Already I noticed corymb. In Caesia auriculata, the inflorescence is corymb. But usually the inflorescence is resin. Now the brief description of flower. The flower brief description is bracteolate, BR, bracteolate, bractate, bracteolate, zygomorphic, bisexual, pentamerous, 5. Pentamerous, cyclic, complete, as well as perigynous flowers are present. Again, brief description of flower. The flower shows bractate, bracteolate, zygomorphic, bisexual, pentamerous, complete, cyclic, perigynous flowers are present. Now we are discussing a detailed description of that flower. So for example, it is the Caesia occidentalis, common name Cassita. Caesia occidentalis twig. These are the simple leaves. These are the fruits. These are the flowers. It is the young fruit. It is twig of Caesia occidentalis Cassita. It is one flower. These are the sepals. The number of the sepals are 5. The number of the sepals are 5. These are the sepals. It is the bract, bracteolates. It is the axis, stem. These are the sepals. The number of sepals are 5. Imbricate aestuation. Imbricate aestuation means 2 sepals are outside. This is completely outside. It is also completely outside. 2 completely inside. This is the inside. It is also inside. 2 outside, 2 inside. One margin is inside, one margin is outside. Such type of arrangement is called imbricate aestuation. So the number of the sepals are 5, imbricate aestuation. Then petals. These are the petals. Usually petals are 5. Except tamarind. In tamarind, the number of petals are 3. Sepals and petals are 3. Saraca indica. In Saraca indica, there is no petals, 0. It is important for entrances. Saraca indica, Sita Ashoka, does not any petals. Tamarindus indica has 3 sepals, 3 petals. But remaining Caesalpinaceae members has 5 petals. The 5 petals are arranged. Imbricate aestuation. It is the posterior. It is the anterior end. Where axis is there, that is indicate anterior end. Where bract is there, that is indicate posterior end. The posterior end petal is masked to the 2 petals. These 2 petals are masking these 2 petals. The masking continues from here to here. The masking. This is called ascending nature. Ascending. So the petals are masking to the 2 petals. These 2 petals are masking to the these 2 petals. Anyhow, the masking continues from down to top. This is called ascending. Aestuation is imbricate. So in Caesalpinaceae, the corolla arrangement is ascending, imbricate, aestuation. Aestuation. From these 5 petals, this side one petal is smaller in size as well as in different color. One petal is small in size, in different color also. So the petal arrangement is called ascending, imbricate, aestuation. The number of petals are 5. Now androecium. Usually the number of stamens are 10. The arrangement is 3 plus 3 plus 4. For example, Caesia. In Caesia species, the number of the stamens, 3 stamens are small. Three stamens are sterile. Four stamens are long. Totally 10 stamens. Three different heights of stamens are arranged. Three are small, three are staminodes, four are long. Then how many fertile? 3 + 4 are fertile. 7 are fertile. How many sterile? 3 are sterile. So in Caesia species, total 10 stamens are there. 7 stamens are fertile. 3 stamens are sterile. So the number of staminodes are 3. Number of fertile stamens are 7. Out of these 7, 3 are small, 4 are long. For example, it is the long stamen. It is the fertile stamen. These are staminodes, sterile stamens. So these are smaller in height, medium height, long height. Three levels of heights maintaining from this flower. For example, in this flower, it is the gynoecium, stigma, style, ovary. These are seeds. These seeds are arranged as marginal placentation. Fertile. These are the fertile, but some are fertile, some are staminodes are there. It is one example, fertile stamen. Now, gynoecium. Unilocular, unicarpellary, marginal placentation with perigynous flower. So, unicarpellary. Unilocular, marginal placentation with perigynous flowers are present. So these are the arrangement of stamens. These three are short, these four are long, these three are staminodes. 3 + 4 + 3, total 7. They are arranged in three heights, three holes. So unicarpellar, unilocular, marginal placentation with perigynous flower. Next, the pollination mechanism, usual insect pollination, but in Delonyx regia, which pollination takes place? Ornithophily. It is important. Ornithophily in Delonyx. The fruit name is legume. But in Tamarindus, indehiscent. The fruit cannot broken after maturity. That fruit is called indehiscent legume in Tamarindus. Remaining all plants are produces legume fruit. Seed, non-endospermic. Seeds are present. The floral formula of Caesalpinaceae, BR, BRL, zygomorphic, bisexual, K5, C5, A10, G1 with perigynous. It is the floral formula. BR, bractate, bracteolate, zygomorphic, hermaphrodite means bisexual, K5, C5, A10, G1 with perigynous. It is the floral formula. Now, important characters of this family. Which are important characters are came in Caesalpinaceae? In Caesalpinaceae, stipules are modified into auricle shape, foliar shape, spines. Auricle shape stipules present in Caesia, auriculata. Foliar shape stipules are present in Delonyx. Spines are present in Parkinsonia. Hematoxylin available from the xylem of Hematoxylon campechianum. It is help to the dying off, staining off nucleus of the cell. It is important for entrances. Ornithophily present in Delonyx regia. Bahinia vahalai. It is one of the lion. Addaku, lion. Unipinnate or bipinnate. Peripinnate. Compound leaves are present. Compound leaves are present. Gums, tannins are present in this family. Gums and tannins. Ascending, imbricate, aestivation present in this family. The petal arrangement, the corolla arrangement is ascending, imbricate, aestivation. The number of stamens are 10 in Caesia species. They are arranged 3 plus 3 plus 4. 3 are short, 3 are sterile, 4 are long. So totally fertile 7, staminodes are 3. So gynoecium is unicarpellary, unilocular with marginal placentation. Marginal placentation is present. As well as the fruit is legume. In Tamarindus, indehiscent legume. The seeds are non-endospermic. Non-endospermic. So these are the some important characters in the Caesalpinaceae. Actually, Caesalpinaceae and Bahin both are scientist name. Gaspard Bahin is one name. Caesalpina is another name. Both are scientist name. Honorarily, the names are put some peculiar plants. Thank you.